when you know what you want to resolve, you convert this into your contribution statement, right? So we want to improve a couple of things. Here, sometimes it's not just one versus one. It could be three versus three, two versus two. So it depends on what your issue here is. So you want to improve loss of substance. So that means to say you want to have good saving. You want things to escape loss of substance. Right? Harmful side effect. You don't want any behaviors and reliability. Okay. So what's stopping us? So the weight. So if it's too heavy, we know we get good seal, but then it's, you know, we are entering a lot more material, and it's not convenient. If let's say if it's too tight in terms of repair and whatnot, it's difficult. So that is the one that is stopping you. So if you solve this, that means you come up with a solution that is, they call it a breakthrough solution. So again, so you can compare, here they call it a 3x3 lah. So you can compare one against this, one against this, one against this, and then second against this one, second. Depends how you do it. But sometimes if you are already savvy enough, you know already, okay, maybe I'll just take one of these against another one, which you feel that that would be the best parameter to look at. So in this case, someone already came up with this idea. What happens is that they just have an inclination to one of the side of the flange. So when you tighten it, it forms a seal. Sometimes it's also related to spring washer and as opposed to normal washer. And spring washer, if you tighten it, then it provides a seal. So this is one of the things that came out of the case. Stop me if I'm moving too far. Okay, yeah.
So if you have a nine matches, then you have to test one by one.
Yeah. But at least you know,
because I meant this one worse and improve one the one exclusion.
Okay, I'll show you there is a technique whereby once you can make a table out of it. Once you get a table, the inventive principle that always comes up first is the one that you get. So you don't do all. So when you compare all, it's good lah. At least you cover semua. But you find out that always that particular number always appear. So that's the one that you want to look at.
Correct.
Yeah. Okay. So there's also some shortcut to it lah. Okay, let's take a look at this thing. It's the wind turbine issue. So it says the faster the speed of the turbine blade, the better the energy capture. But there's a danger of the blades flying off. So they face this when they started doing this. Early on, the wind turbine. Now they solve the problem. So, what they want to have is speed, but what is stopping them is the strength. So they don't want something heavy. They want something lightweight and things like that. But then they want to make sure that they can turn at very high speeds. So, if you compare this as people, they come out with this 8.326 complete. So you may you. Do you want to use all? You may not, or just pick the one that is relevant. In this case, this guy has used this before. He looked at curvature and he looked at the thing. He looked at the turbine and he looked at curvature. It makes sense. So it says here, if you relate to some of the products like propellers, jet engines, compressor, they have a certain design to the propeller, to the blade. So they copy this design and it works. So sometimes it's also existing products out there that you want to when you call that and you make. So the one in your notes a bit elongated, the explanation again, the speaker sikit. Why you choose this, why you don't choose that, and then so yang dalam nota tu lebih elaborate nanti. Case studies. So all these things actually are talking about how you want to use the matrix. So the more you use it, the better you get. Contohnya, I'm just picking up some things that we are doing. Speak general, I tak dapat capture any information. Okay, Muhammad Nizam, you've got four major problems that contribute to major downtime. Slack conveyor, so on so forth, right? Okay, so let's say your problem issue here is downtime, okay. And you have let's say slack conveyor, for instance, yeah. So what you want to improve is uptime, okay. But what's stopping you? Let's say if you take the slack conveyor, there's something there that is you want to improve the uptime but tak boleh. Right? So what you have to identify that first. What is stopping you? And it could be many things. Tak apa. So you list them down first. Yeah? And then you take that, when you structure your contradiction statement, you try to take what you want to improve and you compare it to the other type. Let's say for instance if it's uptime, usually it will lead to more on productivity, maybe to a certain extent measurement accuracy or reliability, depending, but more so I think productivity, and then you compare what is stopping you. Is it got to do with some mechanical problem, operator problem or process related problem? So once you identify that, you try to see whether it's inside this, if not something close to that, yeah? So now you have your parameter. So once you have your parameter, you can check out in the matrix and then get your inventive principle, yeah? So your inventive principles are here and the meaning behind it is also inside your. Is that so far? Okay, not that confusing lah.